have the two biggest stars?
Dos Bunka.
So what's new and exciting?
The release of Triple Ecstasy.
Hey, wait, you directed this movie.
Yes, I did. I did direct this movie. Yes.
So what was your vision for the project?
It has to be alternative, it has to be cool and stylish, but it also has to have really hard, nasty sex, because in the end, that's what matters.
And were you able to elicit that from your performers?
Yeah. Yes. I only hire people that I know are going to do a good job and that are friends of mine, so they like, it's like a team effort.
And is this a safe neighborhood?
No. It is not a safe neighborhood. From, I guess, Crenshaw and Pico, anytime I hear Crenshaw, I shy away. But last time I was here, it was a Friday night, and I walked to my car alone, and I wasn't afraid, so that's my opinion of the safe neighborhood.
What kind of people live around here?
What kind of people live around here, Dennis?
Hardworking, patriotic Americans, much like yourself.
Absolutely. What other parties are you going to tonight?
I've been to two others, and they both suck. The Bondage Ball and the Monstars Party.
Monstars Party.
And I heard the Red Light one was really low, too.
Really?
There's so many parties going
on. There's
so
a lot of parties.
The royalty is spread thin.
Yes. Well, I mean, this is where I wanted to be, so... This is where I am, and Andy from Call Me Christ is DJing, and he's awesome, so this is where I wanted to be, and a lot of people RSVP'd, so...
No, it's a good crowd. It's like several
It's three
crowd.
Levels here. Three
right.
Levels of industrial.
Which level are we on right now?
One. This is like the top level, okay. And then there's like two other levels.
So. And what's going on in the two lower levels?
Industrial.
Industrial music?
Yeah.
What kind of music is this?
Industrial. It's...
So three different types of industrial music?
There's a lot of black clothes in this club.
What does black clothes signify?
It's Halloween, but it's like a gothic industrial crowd, which is the nicest crowd ever. And they're very open and mellow. There won't be any fights here. Two gothic kids won't start a fight.
Oh, okay.
You know, like, it's nice people.
I would have thought, is that true generally? Goths don't get into fights with each other?
Goth kids?
Gothic kids. Is that true generally?
They no, they into- just shoot their school apart.
Okay.
They just bring buckshots into the elementary.
Okay, okay.
Hey, Neil. This is Neil Strauss. He wrote...
Neil!
He wrote...
Luke Ford. Good to meet you, man.
Hey. Fine. I'm okay if I run the camera.
Yeah, no problem.
He wrote Bella Loves Jenna.
Oh, this is so cool. I can't believe I get to meet you.
And a bunch of other stuff.
Yeah, I'd love that. You stop answering your email. You disappear from...
Yeah, you know what I did is... I started keeping track of how I spent all my hours, and I realized I was spending like 8 hours a week answering email, so I decided, fuck it, I'm killing my email.
Right,
the most freeing thing you can ever do.
And you still style?
To some guys, to some people.
I mean, do you still teach that?
Oh yeah, I still teach that. Totally, yeah, a couple of style guys here. I don't live it as much. Well, depends on who you ask. But yeah, but I still teach a couple of my guys over here.
And you're still with the girl from your book?
I'm not. We moved in together. It was awesome. And I'll tell you what, I don't know if you know this, but relationships are much harder than meeting people.
Have you ever been married?
No, have you?
No. I'm 41. How old are you?
I'm in the 30s. But how do you feel about that?
I want to be married.
Yeah, same.
I mean, I belong to an Orthodox Jewish community. So,
do you really? Yeah, that's right.
So it's like I'm a total, you know, outlying, you know, by not being married. Everyone's married. So.
Yeah, and I feel like I want to be the cool dad.
Yeah.
Like, if your kids were 18 now, you would like get along with them. You'd like the same kind of music.
Yeah, yeah.
But like by the time your kids are 18 now, you'll be like fucking almost 60.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I'll be geriatric.
So you gotta like, yeah. So I really feel like I want to have kids in time to be the cool dad. But what do you think? It's a personal failing of yours that you're not able to.
Yeah, I think it's definitely a personal failure.
Yeah. And what do you think it is?
I think it's like the biggest indictment of myself, right. You know, short of being arrested for something. Yeah, you know, it's exactly. Like, I think it's a failure of me having my life together.
Yeah, exactly.
I wish I could escape, you know, some other explanation, but right. I see no other explanation.
I know, I feel like you haven't evolved to the next stage of
healing. Yeah, yeah.
You're over the whole validation cycle.
Yeah. I remember in high school, I wasn't a very good student. Right. And at one point in my junior or senior year, I thought I had to retake freshman English.
Right.
And I feel like that was such a humiliating feeling.
Right, exactly.
That I still have nightmares about it,
yeah,
things
it's so
like
weird.
That.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm sort of living that now. Like all my friends are married with kids.
Right.
And I'm left behind.
You know, it's a great book. It's called Mastering Your Hidden Self by Serge Kahaly King. I'll email you the information, but
okay.
It's great. It's all about like breaking those patterns. It's really good. What's your longest relationship? Have you ever been close?
Last one was 14 months.
Right.
So,
right.
I mean, the last 10 years, we start talking about marriage a few months in, you know, if not earlier. So
And why did it end?
The last one, because I didn't think she was right for me. I mean, she hadn't had a job in 8 months. And,
right.
And then the other ones they just weren't right. I mean, here I am, you know, converting to Judaism, and I'm always dating chicks. It's like really self-defeating. So
that's weird. What's up with that?
Yeah, I don't know. I think I've had some of them explain it's because I know that it can't work. That,
yeah.
You know, therefore I feel free to.
Yeah.
You know, and I was on J-Date for a month, and I went 0 for 120.
You're kidding. All my friends who get on J-Date get married. I'm too scared to get on J-Date.
Well, Google's my enemy. As soon as they put my name into Google,
same here. I got to hurry up and get the next book out about something else.
Yeah.
Because as soon as you put my name, it's like pickup artist.
Yeah. When's your next book coming out?
It's coming out December 18th. It's still about game type stuff. One book's out too, another one's about my own failures and relationships. You know, and the stuff, it's like the question, what do you do after the orgasm? Is what the story book is about. And the other one's more the how-to side of the game. But I want to hurry up and get the book after that out, because that's about politics, and maybe that'll change my mood. Search results.
How often do you regret being style as a whole, you know, being so successful with your style?
You can't. I think you're an asshole if you regret it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There are like drawbacks and shitty things.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Like, people always have their guard up, but you're an asshole if you regret it, because what's the opposite? The opposite is there are no repercussions, but there are no repercussions because no one read it.
Right.
So I don't regret
it. Successful.
Yeah. What I do think sometimes is, you know, it would have been very classy to just do it and then walk away.
Right.
But there's something about that whole.
It's addictive, isn't it?
Yeah, it's addictive.
It's addictive.
Yeah, it's addictive.
What do you think about the theory that the whole conquest thing is addictive?
I wonder if it's conquest. I'll tell you this one.
Here, let me tell you.